Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, Sean Locke, John Richardson, Joe Lysak, Michelle Wolf, Sean Bean, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, anglomatophilia is a sexual attraction to mannequins? It's very rare, which is why it took me so long to find a girlfriend. What the Americans call moonshine, the Irish call poutine and the Scottish call hand sanitizer. And 25 years is the amount of time the average human spends sleeping in their lifetime, although that increases significantly if that human's been given one of Susie Dent's books. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. The brilliant thing about John being here is... No, I got nothing. And John's teammate, Joe Lysak. Joe attended Manchester Met University and studied drama, which is a lovely way to tell your dad you're gay.
I actually went to the proper university, actually. Manchester University.
As opposed
to
Manchester...
Get your facts straight, you prick.
You were fine with the rest of that, though?
Yeah, fine with the rest of it. I'm just getting through.
OK, up against them this evening is Sean Locke.
Thank you.
Sean's quick wit, charming personality and incredible ability with numbers are just none of the reasons he's on the show tonight. And joining Sean tonight is Michelle Wolf. Michelle is from America, and fun fact, Americans have started their own version of Countdown by electing Donald Trump.
What are you gonna do?
Michelle, you're up against John tonight. Do you have weird nerds like John in America?
I mean, we have weird nerds, but maybe none as nerdy as John.
I've seen Bill Gates.
Bill Gates does not dress as Rupert the Bear.
What's plaid?
We call plaid Czech.
You call it Czech?
Yeah.
Not anymore, not after Brexit.
No. How do you spell it? Is it with an I?
Played.
Played.
Yeah, played. P-L-A-I-D.
5 points to us.
Okay, it's plaid.
Does it need to be that
plaid.
Nasal?
Plaid. I want you to play a shirt.
Oh, God, I want to invade.
I'm gonna have this conversation my next first date.
Okay, Sean, when you're feeling down in the dumps, how do you cheer yourself up?
Well, see, that's the thing, that's the mistake everyone makes about me, is that I'm actually, my big problem is coming down. I'm just, you know, people are high on life. I'm shit-faced on life. But, you know, if I want to bring myself down, I'll go to, like, a random pet funeral. Just stand at the back with the postman. And wonder, who's that mysterious spaniel in the veil? Or, you know, sometimes if I just need it, if I need to quickly just, let's just drop everything down, Sean, you're getting too carried away. I just sit on the toilet. And think about Gary Barlow.
Are your pants down? Are you just sitting on the toilet?
If you like. it's up to you. You can imagine it any way you want. I've got one foot on the door because there's no knock on it.
So pants down.
Yeah.
Joe, it says here you've tried to sell fake stories to the tabloids.
So, yeah, I try and sell stories that haven't happened. For example, I tried to sell a story that I saw Alison Hammond punching a cat.
Sorry, Alison Hammond?
Oh, Alison Hammond, she's the woman on This Morning.
You can win a car!
That one.
That was
That's really good. Yeah.
If you can answer this question, what do you sit on, a chair or the concept of fear?
OK, John, question for you. What are your favourite things about yourself?
I give blood a lot.
You give blood a lot?
Well, I have nosebleeds, but it all all goes in the there, system, yeah. Doesn't it, I think. I think I've got just the right amount of body hair. I think I've just got enough. I've got it there, but not there, and there, but not here. I think that's just right.
You've got a heart-shaped chest hair.
Yeah, it just comes around there. It's just nice. A treat for me and the masses. Sorry, misses.
OK, Joe, have you got a mascot? What did you bring?
Oh, yes. It's something I've been using recently to predict the future.
Right.
They're tarot cards.
Oh.
But they're not any old tarot cards.
No.
They're gay tarot cards. I found these in a shop in Birmingham, and the idea is I want to go to festivals as my drag act, Nigella Farage. and read people's gay tarots. So I thought I could read yours as a start. I'm going to use them during the show to help me get the answers. What I need you to do is to get your gay energy into those. Feel the part of you go into them.
And then what, give them back to you? Or?
Yeah, yeah, and then I will take... what I'll do is I'll read your gay future.
Sure.
All right.
Oh, it's exciting.
Are you gay in any way, Jimmy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, the cards will never lie. Oh, that one feels about right. So your gay tarot. Oh, look at that. Oh, it's the Four of Swords. That is a gay, and he's having a lie down on some seats there.
Okay, I look borderline homeless there. What does that mean?
Yeah, you're going to be homeless.
I don't have good gaydar, so how can you tell that's a gay asleep on some chairs?
Because it's gay tarot.
Ah! I see. And if I just walked into that room...
And this will be your gay future.
You're sort of suggesting that one.
Well, let's put that one over there, then, if you don't want it. Or do you want it?
Oh, I don't know.
I think it's calling to me. I think he wants it.
I think I do want it. This whole game seems pointless.
Oh, look, it's the Ace of Cups. That's a gay being waved off. So that means you're leaving, basically.
On a plane?
And that's your family going, bye, you're gay, get out.
OK. Right, Michelle, have you got a mascot?
I did. Well, you might have known we elected Donald Trump as the... Yeah, thank you. All of you are excited? Great. Yeah, you feel happy and safe? Okay, good, so do we. One of his big platforms he was running on was he had hats, which is really important for a country.
Yeah, good policy.
Yeah. So I made this Make America Great Again hat, but I made some rum and cokes. In there. So now I can make America... Nope.
No, the other end, presumably.
So, yeah, you need to stick that in there.
Oh, I put it in there. Great, got it.
OK, there you go.
Yeah, you're going to really make America great. Wait. It might come out down on his shirt. Just in case. Because neither of us are plumbers. Hat plumbers.
Oh, that saved you.
That would have gone everywhere. Jesus.
I felt like this will help me. Oh no.
Oh no.
I've really gotten it everywhere.
John, have you got a mascot?
Well, I've written another book, Jimmy. Hey, Joe, can I just ask, what's your favourite kind of food? Couldn't give a shit, mate. You're dull.
It's the new John. What?
I've noticed this year, what with Donald, it sort of stopped being a good thing to be nice to people, I think. And actually, the thing now is to be as rude as you can. I mean, look at you, Jimmy. You're constantly horrific to everybody on this show. You've never paid anyone a single compliment in the history of this show, and nobody says anything. So I've decided that I'm not going to be nice anymore. I've written a new book so you can learn from me. It's called How to Lose Friends and Influence Even More People. And it's just about being a shitbag, really, at all times. So just being a turd. Don't take interest in anyone. Everyone's a prick. You're all dickheads. And it's just tips, really. Don't smile at any point, especially in photos, so people know you mean business.
You're smiling on the cover.
You fucking idiot.
You're really getting the hang of this, Joe. Well done.
Yeah, I like it.
I've got a good tactic for if I'm in a conversation that I'm not enjoying anymore, or if I want to be heard but the conversation's moved on, I'll just start screaming.
How does a scream sound from you?
It depends on what sort of conversation I'm trying to interrupt. I mean, we'll have to see when the conversation moves on, really.
Sean, have you got a mascot? Sean, do you have a mascot?
Yeah, I do, Jimmy, yeah. The thing you might have noticed about me over the years that I don't do many adverts.
You know what? I've noticed that, yeah.
And it's not an ethical, it's not a moral thing. I just have never found a product to which I feel I can really commit myself. Recently, I've launched my own website and my own business, and I feel like I should be the voice of this new business. So, and I'd actually like, I thought it might be a bit of fun to do it for you tonight. So I'd like to record my ad for you with the voiceover. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Need some money? Got an old canal boat lying around? Then phone me, the captain, and I'll turn your floating rat trap into hard cash or gold. At WeBuyAnyCanalBoat.com, we'll pay good money for all canal-worthy craft, with or without a certificate of canal-worthiness. Visit one of our friendly flagship canal boat valuation centres. We're very easy to find, even in the fog. Or just send us a rough estimate of your mounting debts. Turn your unwanted craft into cash or gold. At WeBuyAnyCanalBoat.com, we put the can into canal. And the anal boat into canal boat. Terms and conditions may apply. All craft must be delivered to our valuation centre at owner's expense using our in-house transportation fleet. At WeBuyAnyCanalBoat.com, we reserve the right not to buy any canal boat. Initial offer may seem much bigger than actual payment received. We are members of ABTA, but as we're not travel agents, it's useless. By agreeing to watch this advert, your house may be at risk. Calls charged at proper premium rates. Callers must be 8 years or older and do not need the bill payer's permission. Just pick up the phone, dial the number, and then go out and play. Nothing the captain says, does, writes, or thinks is legally binding.
Sean Lott's advert, everyone. And making a return to Dictionary Corner this week, the living legend that is Sean Bean.
Bastards. Sean spelt like Bean and Bean spelt like Sean. Put them both together and you got an actor that Martin Scorsese once called by mistake.
Well, welcome back, Sean. I'm surprised to see you here tonight.
Oh, I'm not averse to doing a sequel if the money's right.
I'm actually more surprised that you're here given the reaction to your last appearance.
What are you talking about?
It wasn't good, Sean. Are you on Twitter at all?
Do I look like I've got 140 characters in me? I've barely got one.
Susie has some of their feedback. I'd brace yourself if I were you.
Yes. Cats Does Countdown are really scraping the barrel with this one joke, Sean Bean prick.
Bastard.
Just not funny. Accent, bad. Material, bad. The only thing that would have made this worse is if you did it all in a suit of armour.
Bastard.
Right, so how do you feel about that, Sean?
Oh, shell-shocked, I'm not going to lie. That's the best reviews I've ever had in my life.
Sean Bean, everyone. And with Sean, of course, it's Susie Dent.
Yeah,
Susie regularly gives talks on lexicography where members of the public get to ask insightful questions such as, how long is this going to go on for and do I have to stay? Susie, you're a wordsmith. If you chose one word to describe me, what would it be?
Gosh, so many choices. Whittling. Somebody who thinks he's funny but is not.
Has she read your book?
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Yay! Rachel joined the regular Countdown team 6 years ago in January 2009, which means she's outlived nearly a million Countdown viewers.
What year is it, Jimmy?
2017.
How many years ago was 2009?
I mean... What? You're in charge of the maths.
That's not the main bit to object to in the insult.
Well, that's once I hear bad maths, I can't hear anything else. I'm just focused.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's good to know. OK, tonight the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Sean and John Boyfriend Pillows. Let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and Joe, you get the first book of the letters.
OK. Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
C.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
T.
Cute. I'm done. We don't need any more. Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
S.
What do you think? What should we have now?
Consonant.
B.
And another one.
Oh, yeah, nice.
K.
And anything that isn't a U.
And I.
Yeah, that'll do.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. She's fucking heavy. Sean, how many... OK, same time again next week. You're getting better. John, how many?
Seven.
Joe, how many?
Seven.
Sean?
Six.
Michelle?
Seven, but I'm positive I spelled it wrong.
Sean, what's your six?
Cuties.
Stop at you. Joe, you're seven?
Buckets.
Buckets.
As in more than one bucket.
Thank you.
Buckets.
Yeah. Thank you. That saved us going over to Dictionary Corner for the definition of buckets. John, you're seven?
Buckets.
Buckets as well.
It's never as good the second time.
Michelle, you're seven, that's risky.
Biscuit, but it's not spelled right.
How have you spelled it?
I put an E for the I. The second I.
Yeah, but there might be some weird old English.
I thought maybe there was. You guys put E's everywhere.
Yeah. Biscuit.
That looks like a sign for a biscuit company in the UK that isn't run by someone from the UK. Biscoet UK. The finest biscoets.
Susie, is Biscuit UK a word?
Sadly not.
Okay, 7 points to John and Joe. Dictionary Corner, could they have done me better?
No. Buckets, cuties, and Susie found a six.
Yeah, me being me. Suck it. A suck it spoon is a utensil for eating fruit.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Joe are in the lead with seven. Right, on to our first numbers game. Sean, Michelle, your turn to pick the numbers.
Can I have two from the top and the rest from elsewhere, please?
Thanks, Sean. Two large, four little. And okay. They are eight,
yep.
Two, three, five, and the big one's 175. And the target, 558.
And your time starts now. So the target was 558. Sean, did you get it?
Mm-hmm.
OK. Michelle, did you get it?
557.
John, did you get it?
Well, I'm one off as well. I got 958.
Joe, did you get it?
I got 554.
Sean, how did you do it?
8 times 75.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
75, 600.
100 divided by 2. 50. 50. Take that away. Then 3 plus 5.
Well done, Sean.
That's good. Okay, 10 points to Sean. Okay, over to Dictionary Corner. Sean, what have you got over there?
The script I'm auditioning for.
Oh, right, are you checking out where you die?
That's a myth, my friend. I don't die in my films. Not if you watch them backwards.
Why on earth would I watch your films backwards?
Why on earth would you watch them forwards?
Fair enough.
This one's a romantic comedy. I play one of the lovers in it. But I need someone to test me on my lines. Lord Lysett, would you do me this honour?
Yeah.
Pass that along. Gratitude. I've taken the liberty to change the names of the characters just so it's easier to remember. So I'll be playing Sean.
OK, who am I playing?
Not Sean.
Yeah.
Action.
Sean, I have feelings for you.
What's me line?
As do I.
Right, I'm never going to remember that. Change it to bastard. Action.
Sean, I have feelings for you.
Bastard.
I need to feel your body against mine.
No, I've gone blank. What's me line?
As do I.
All right. They're just not sticking. Change that one to bastard as well. But this time add a touch of arousal.
What? Me or you?
Both of us.
I need to feel your body against mine.
Bastard.
It says here they kiss.
Right.
Be gentle.
Done.
No, we're not.
Hey, take a gay tarot while you're at it.
John Bean, everyone. Has that awoken anything deep within you, Sean?
It certainly made the armour slightly tighter.
And here is your teaser. The words are neat pole. The clue is watch out for the horn. That's neat pole. Watch out for the horn. See you after the break. The answer to the teaser, the words were neat pole, the clue was watch out for the horn. It was, of course, antelope. So Sean and Michelle are in the lead. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Michelle and John. So, Michelle, your turn to choose the letters.
Vowel.
Thanks, Michelle.
E. Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
Zed.
I'm doing this to make John mad. Consonant.
At some point, the authorities will step in.
Consonant.
W.
Consonant.
I don't think you can have that many consonants.
Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police.
You really are a tattletale.
two
more vowels, yeah.
Two more.
I'm stepping in.
So
here,
John doesn't get his panties in a bunch.
And A.
Well, if it was the Polish countdown, you'd be fine.
Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the Polish.
Okay, your time starts now. Oh, I've done my hamstring. Michelle, what have you got?
Seven.
Honestly, Susie, I don't know how you... Oh. John, what have you got? How many?
Six.
Right, what was your six? John?
Reaped.
Reaped. Michelle, your seven?
Tweezer.
Tweezer?
Yeah.
Yay!
You need three E's for tweezer.
Does that have an EA?
No.
I feel like I'm getting reaped.
I thought I was about to lose to someone in their second language.
6 points to John.
Pretty rich to be able to have a room for a sex swing.
It can double up, can't it?
Or just a regular chair?
You could be watching TV or, you know.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Netflix and swing.
It's quite a conversation to have, though, isn't it? To say, should we get one of these? Or you just sneak it in one day. Yeah, just come home with it. I bought something, start putting it together. It's not until the last, very last bits are swinging, you go, fuck off.
I mean, any swing's a sex swing if you do someone on it, right?
And that's why John's banned from the park.
Yeah.
Sean, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, a few sevens there. Trapeze. Watered and tapered.
Thanks, slightly scary man.
You want it again?
Yeah, but more gruff.
Watered. Trapeze. What was the other one?
Okay, so at the end of that, Sean and Michelle have 10, John and Joe have 13. Now time for Sean and Joe to go head-to-head. Joe, your turn to pick the numbers.
I will have two big ones and then the other ones, little ones.
Thank you, Joe. Two large, four little. And they are 5, 2, 6 and 8.
Yeah.
And
they're the big ones,
25 and 100.
Oh, I like them.
And the target, 668.
OK, and your time starts now. Okay, so the target was 668. Did you get it?
667.
Me too.
Okay, Joe, how did you get 667?
6 times 100 is 600. 8 times 5 is 40.
Yeah.
Then you add the 25 to make 665.
Yeah.
And then the other two, 667.
Yeah, one away. Well done.
7 points to Joe. Solid. Sean, did you do it in the same way?
No, I did it. 5 plus 2 is 7.
Yeah.
Times 100.
700.
And then 25 plus 8. Take that away.
Yeah, well done.
7 points to Sean. Rachel, could it be done?
Well, 2 times 5.
2 times 5, I'm comfortable with, OK.
Add it to the 100 for 110.
110, yeah, fine.
Times it by 6.
Yeah.
660. Chuck on an 8.
Chuck on an 8.
Boom. Wow.
668. OK, so Sean and Michelle have 17, John and Joe have 20. Time for another trip over to Dictionary Corner. Sean Bean, as an actor, you are the definition of incredible.
Meaning hard to believe. Yeah, that's high praise indeed. There's a reason for that. I'm what is known in this game as a triple threat. Threat number one, I've got a face like Ayers Rock at dusk. Threat number two, I can fashion a noose out of an Albert morning breath. And threat number three, I've got wonderfully musical hair.
Musical hair?
Yeah, it's true. If you grab a right good clump of my thatch and strum it with all your heart, you can create a sound born truly of the gods. You want to see it?
More than anything.
Right, let's do this. You, front row, front and centre. Let's go. Get up. Here we go. What's your name?
Guy.
Sean. Great. Now, tell me, Sean, have you ever played a man's air before?
No, I can't yeah. have.
Well, you're in for a treat. His powers. Yeah, oh, he's a good lad. Good lad. Yeah, mount that. That's it. Now get your legs as wide as you can get them. Wider than that. Oh, wider. Hitch up your pants and tell your balls to pick a lane. That's it. Good lad. Get in. Yeah, that's all right, isn't it? Now, with your right hand, open it right up. That's it. Dig it right into me head snatch. That's it. Grab a clump, lift it up, and then with your other hand, play me, you bastard. Do it! With your other hand. There you go. That's it. Wonderful. I'll give you a minute till you find the beat. Or not. It's a wonderful feeling, though. Not much beats that. But one thing does. You, glasses, get in here. Come on. Let me play you. Slow down. Slow down. Right down. Let's see. I'll try and maneuver my way around the product. What have we got here? OK, let's give it a go. Let's have a look. Here we go. How's that? That's good. You, Frank, get in there. Let him play you. And you. Let's get it all in. Everyone, get up. Frank, get up. You, Pat, get in here! Everybody! Frank, get him up, get his groin! Let's keep going, and you, come on! Let's create a human centre beam! Imagine if this was just the rest of the show! I'd still watch it. How's about that? Give a round of applause, that's airplane, all right? There you go, sir. Well done, good job. It's great airplane right there. I'll take care of this. There you go, lad. You did us proud. You did us proud, eh? Now, you bastards! Shh!
Did you just kill the chair? Sean Bean, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are free dump. The clue is smells pretty good. That's free dump. Smells pretty good. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were free dump. The clue was smells pretty good. It was, of course, perfumed. OK, on with the game. John and Joe, your turn to choose the letters.
Ooh, what fun.
How's that acting class going?
He's great.
Thanks, Sean. Vowel.
I can still smell him on your breath.
A bit like stubble rash. You choose now, baby girl.
If I pick one, then I sort of condone that as a way of... I don't know, open the gate.
Come on, baby girl. Sweet baby girl.
Come on, little baby girl, you pick a letter.
Little bubba. Little bubba, pick a letter, my little bubba.
Big daddy.
Rachel's big daddy.
I have a child now. I don't have to put up with this. Daddy would like a consonant.
What does Daddy want next?
Daddy would like another consonant, please.
Vowel, please.
Oh, let Mummy pick one. Daddy would like a consonant.
G.
Another consonant.
N.
Vowel, please.
I.
Consonant. And a consonant.
V. Ooh.
Ooh, vag. Oh, no.
You want to change?
Oh, yeah, great. Consonant. Let's see if I can spell this.
If it's.
Oh, no, you need another vowel. Another vowel, please.
Vowel.
Yeah! And your time that you definitely don't need because we already know what you've all got starts now.
Daddy.
What did Daddy get?
Daddy got an 8.
Joe, what did you get?
6 letters, baby.
Michelle, what did you get?
7.
7. Sean?
4.
What's your 4?
It's risky.
What is it?
Because there's actually a word called gain up there.
You got gain.
Oh, you should have had... You missed the obvious.
No, I didn't want that. I'm happy with my 4.
Joe, what is your 6?
Gallant.
Spelling it with 1 L.
Oh, shit.
It's a shame because you've written it so big as well.
You can spell it that way, but it means something different. It means a light and elegant style of music.
I was thinking of it when I was listening to Sean's music. Well, how gallant that music is. I really feel it in my vagina.
And Michelle, what did you get? What was your 7?
Tailing?
Tailing?
Yeah, like chasing tail.
It sounds a very American word. Is that a thing, Rachel?
Susie?
Susie.
Yes.
Jimmy, we colour-coded them to make it easier for you.
So the evil one's in black. OK, Susie. that works, Taylor?
Yeah, tail is there as a verb. All okay. sorts of meanings.
John, you're 8?
Availing.
Very.
Oh, wow.
Very, very good.
Availing.
Yeah, yeah, good.
Sean, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, availing was excellent. Vigilant. Is 8 and aviating for 8 as well.
So at the end of that, John and Joe are in the lead with 28. Okay, over to Dictionary Corner. Sean, anything else for us?
Oh, I could show you how I get in top class physical shape.
Please.
Okay. You, up here. Join me. What's your name?
Guy.
Sean. Great, perfect. Sean laughs. Sean laughs. Now, this is Yakult. Adrenaline-flavoured cheese in a bottle. Legend has it that if you skull one of these, you get a stomach as hard as the alphabet. So it stands to reason that if you stick 2 dozen of these to your chest, you can make your torso nigh on impregnable. This, my friend, is the Yak Rack 3000. It's 3 lines of drinking yoghurt that have been specifically designed to give your torso the hardness of 17 erect adult penine. It's the ultimate armour for the ultimate warrior. But don't take my word for it. Put on them boxing gloves and punch me till my tits split. Get in the position now. Just take care. An initial shot, find your range. A little bit harder. That's it, Tiger, unleash hell. Go on, that's it, go on, keep going. That's it, that's it, that's it, keep going. Bastard, 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 this ended 2 minutes ago. Bastard, bastard, there you go, all right. Easy, Tiger, give him a round of applause right there. Well done, champ. Still standing. Still standing.
Would you like a flannel, Sean?
No, I'll just sit here and act myself clean.
Sean Bean, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are oral night. The clue is keep it in the family. That's oral night, keep it in the family. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were oral night. The clue was keep it in the family. It was, of course, relation. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Michelle, your turn to choose the letters.
Consonant, please.
Thanks, Sean. N. Consonant, please. S.
Vowel.
E. Vowel.
I.
Cats in N.
Penis!
I'm going to get parsnip out of this if it fucking... consonant, please.
N.
Consonant, N. Please.
W.
Vowel, please.
G.
Vowel.
Vowel.
Man, it's a sexy language, huh?
I'm going to go with that.
O. OK. And your 30-second starts now.
This week on planet Earth, we are in the freezing, snowy terrain of Siberia.
Welcome to Pointless. One more person for me to introduce, it's my Pointless friend, is Richard.
Richard Osman, everyone!
Sean, how many?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Michelle?
I've got an 8.
John?
I'll say 7 as well.
Joe?
I got distracted because Richard Osman was here. So I've only got the 5 that I had earlier.
Joe, what's your 5?
Penis.
Susie, is it in there?
Sorry. I was miles away.
Well, yeah, just the mention of it.
What are we looking for? Penis.
Penis is in
penis
there.
Penis is definitely in, yes.
Great.
Plural is penises or pennies.
Yeah. Sean, you're 7?
Pennies.
And John, you're 7?
Pension. Yes.
Yeah,
I like to bring a dull word. There's penis there. No, I'd like to talk about people's financial futures.
And Michelle, you're 8?
It's more of a slogan than it is a word.
Right, this doesn't bode well.
Penis now!
I think there's a good chance it's in Susie's dictionary.
No, it's not there, unfortunately.
Well, 7 points to both teams. Dictionary corner. Could they have done any better?
No, to 7's over here. Pens. Pen.
Sorry, if you run out of battery, you're dying. What happened there? What?
Action. No, nothing over here. Just 2 7s, pennies and pension.
OK, so Sean and Michelle have 24. John and Joe have 35. So you're playing for pride.
1 point.
Figures on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
Opposites.
Let's have a look. Sean Lott with a conundrum there in 3 seconds. So the final scores are Michelle and Sean have 34, but the winners today with 35, John and Joe. So congratulations, you're now the proud owners of these, the Countdown Sean and John Boyfriend Pillows. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Back to its usual slot, 10 o'clock tomorrow night in Channel 4, live last leg of the week that was with the brilliant Kathy Burke. First dates next tonight, quick snog,